pretty soon.
Sam, we're going to get started.
Yes, yes, we are. Okay,
ladies and gentlemen, we'll get ourselves started. If any of you are concerned that your picture might go into the post office from here, I want you to know that will not happen. You will not see your picture in the post office. We have nothing to worry about yet. For those of you who don't care, you know, people in the post office are using the 10 plus 1. That's supposed to be a joke. I'll keep it to myself. All right. First of all, those of you who don't know, my name is Barry Bloodline. I'm the president of the Eastern Military Academy Alumni Association. And as many organizations that are here today, we also try to do good deeds throughout the community, and in many cases, people do good deeds throughout the world. And for those of you who also don't know, from 1947 through 1979, this facility was Eastern Military Academy. You're right now sitting in our gym. And believe it or not, at both ends was a basketball hoop. And as Gary will share with you, what he has done today here is really kind of phenomenal. It is my pleasure to introduce individuals that are here today to honor the Wounded Warrior Project. First of all, Congressman Stephen Israel could not be here, but Luke Connors, who works diligently for him, is here today. You will be able to see him at LaGuardia if you have time tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. He'll be flying in for an event. But otherwise, we have Luke representing him today, and he's sorry he couldn't be with us today. Representing the Rockettes Alumni Association is Cheryl Anderson, and representing Oheka Castle, speaking last, will be Gary Mealings. Today, the United States has faced many different conflicts, from Civil War, World War I, World War II, and the Korean War, and as all of us may have been involved with the Vietnam War. Today, we face various conflicts regarding the jihad in Iran, Iraq, and both Pakistan and Afghanistan. Today, I'm sorry to say many of us will not be fortunate enough in our lifetime to see peace on this earth. For some reason, there's just a lot of people out there that would rather give up their life for other reasons. But today, the Wounded Warriors, which was started in 2003, the Wounded Warrior Project, was started and its goals and objectives are to assist military personnel and help them return to normal life as soon as possible, as well as helping families. I am also happy to, after reviewing the Wounded Warriors Financial Project, that over almost 82% of all the money that they raise goes to benefit soldiers here in the United States, probably throughout the world. And if any of you ever investigated other charitable organizations, you have found that 82% is a very high percentage money going for the cause and not for necessarily salaries and other obligations like that. To share more information, I'm going to invite Paul Hastings, who is from the Wounded Warrior Project. I presume his goal is he really represents Long Island. I probably presumed wrong. I should have asked, forgive me. But he will bring us up to date on that. And along with him is a young lady who is a lieutenant from the Navy who served for our country and is part of the Wounded Warrior Projects, and also has the assistance of her lovely boxer who helps her get around when she needs it. So at this time, I'll just ask Mr. Hastings to please come up and please share some thoughts about the Wounded Warrior Projects for us, please.
Thank you, Brevity. I learned a long time ago, brevity is the better part of valor. Right, gentlemen? We started in 2003 applying a simple backpack to a soldier or member of the armed forces in a hospital. As we went along, needs grew greater every day. More things had to be addressed. There were more issues we had to approach and solve the problem for these vets. They weren't being taken care of in the right way. Fortunately, I'm glad to say that I was there when it started. This is our 10th anniversary this year, and we're very proud of that. And we will continue to serve the vets as long as they need it. We're not going away. We don't have a clubhouse. We're not running a catering hall. We focus on the vet and their family, whatever their needs are. We're a little bit unique because we have two schools where we take the vets away for an entire year, pay for their housing, their meals, and provide them with college courses, IT courses, internships with major corporations, enable that they can readily transgress or transform from the military back into a civilian role. Also, we have evolving out of that was the Warriors to Work program, where we make sure the kids have a good job. Now this McDonald's nonsense at $7.95 an hour. We make sure they get good, substantial jobs for the skills that they have learned and earned in the military. It's become a very successful program. Many unions have come and approached us. They want us to send them the kids. Here on Long Island, I've gotten kids with the Carpenters Union, the Plumbers Union, the Electricians. I've got them with a bunch of major corporations out here, all kinds of financial organizations, industrial organizations, because we've got a lot of businesses here on the island. And they need skilled people, and they need responsible people, and that's what we send them. We tell them they're going to be there at 9 o'clock in the morning. Those people are there at 9 o'clock in the morning without any excuse. They're ready to go. We have a fabulous PTSD program. This is the latest thing. Now, they worry about this post-traumatic stress disorder. So, we have one of the best post-traumatic stress disorder programs of any veterans organization around. We were the first to start that. All right? And as other needs evolve, we're always ready to go and be there and be first. You will notice that some of the salaries on our staff are rather high. Yes, they are. Because when you got to hire the best to give the best to the best people on the face of this earth, and these are these vets, that's why those salaries are what they are. I have highly skilled, qualified people taking care of these programs for these kids. And that's where we're at today. And I want to thank you, Barry, for asking me here. And I hope you all have a good lunch.
Thank you very much. The work that you do for our returning home soldiers. I would now like to invite Cheryl Anderson, member of the Rockettes Alumni Association, which was started in 1953. Their mission and goal is to be a philanthropic organization to foster the close bond and friendship among its alumni members. There are approximately 435 members that range from age 22 to 92. And I've asked Cheryl to say a few words on behalf of the alumni here, and I thank the ladies who joined us here today for coming out for them. So Cheryl, without further ado, I'd like you to come on up.
With great pride, I would like to present, on behalf of the Rockette Alumni Foundation, a donation check in the amount of $1,000.
Why don't you guys go to Jane and picture with her? Why she gives it to you. Okay? Now let's do it.
But I also have friends who found out that we were coming here for this, and the note that they wrote, they donated personally a $25 check. Frank and I would like to share, would like to thank you for your dedication to the Wounded Warrior Project. This is an extraordinary foundation, and we are very proud of the work they do to aid our wounded servicemen and women. God bless you and all who help the project. With love and appreciation, Louise and Frank. So here's another donation check.
You're welcome.
And two representatives of our Rockies alumni, and God bless you for all that you do, and We do pray for our service people. They are wonderful.
Okay, everyone look this way for a second.
Mr. Hastings and behalf, and then we're all gonna come up here for pictures. You can all come up here. Just find someone else to take a picture. Okay, we're gonna leave Will stand over here, but on behalf of Eastern Military Academy,
I'll take one picture. What about yours?
Why don't we take a picture over here and then I'll invite Gary.
Get it stored and we'll get you up there.
It's just a good flashback.
Oh.
When it stops.
Okay. Gotcha.
What's the merit of that?
Just show her what's in the drawer. Come on, I'll listen.
I don't know when you're gonna be in the window.
Okay, can you get everyone in? Are you good at photography? You look like a professional. Many of us have had the occasion to be at the fair here at Oheka, and I think all of us have read or heard about Mr. Gary Milius, who once was a school for us, took a dilapidated building that was destroyed by adults, children, drunks, drug addicts, saw something here that perhaps many other people didn't see. But he saw an opportunity to restore a building to become a landmark historical preserved building. He has taken our gymnasium from a gym to a beautiful cocktail hour room. And it's just a phenomenal job that he has done. And to the military, Eastern Military Academy alumni, Gary has been a supporter completely for us. Whenever we needed a place to meet, his hospitality has been significantly generous. We've had events here that were as good as weddings or bar mitzvahs, and Gary was always there that helped us make sure that this is an event. As I tell people, even in California, if you're ever invited to a wedding or bar mitzvah at Oheka Castle, it's worthwhile coming. If you're ever invited to a fair here not to be here, you're missing something. I was at a wedding here, they had trumpets on the gardens, playing music as the bride and groom walked down. Plus, it's a place that most memorable fairs on Long Island, but Oheka is a location for many movies and TV shows. If you watch Royal Pains, I think they've been probably the biggest pain here. They've been here longer than anyone else, and they did a lot of their time here. I'm going to invite Gary to please come up here, share some key events that have taken place here at Oheka, and made this a place for a destination for many. And Gary, if you don't mind coming up, I will share one thing before you do come up. Hyathan has been very helpful, and Mary Ellen, who's not here today, she's off today, has been a key contact for me in making this a reality. So I thank her very much also. And if you'd like to say a few words before we invite them up, please do so.
Thank you.
Let me get the hot water first. A few words. No, I had no idea to come up here and say anything, so I'm at a loss. Does anybody want to ask me a question or something? I'm not really good at speech.
I heard, tell me if this is true, that when Tiger Woods played out here at the Bethpage U.S. Open for Golf, that he rented your entire facility for the entire time period for his staff and everything. Is that a true fact?
It would have been if he paid me, but no, it was not a fact. He wasn't even here.
Really?
You know, like a lot of things, you know, he cares a lot of stories, tunnels downstairs, tunnels to the water.
There was a tunnel to the water.
No. Let me give you maybe something to put in perspective. The Queens Midtown Tunnel is 1 mile long. You know, long
right.
It's 5 miles to the water.
Was there a train station out
there? There is a train station. It's still there, current Cold Spring Harbor train station. Which, if you There is a tunnel under this back wall, which is the employee entrance. So they walk in, they just walk a quarter of a mile across, you know, across the property. But to get to it now, some people have to go around. But that's the only tunnel. It's
we used to sneak out of that tunnel.
Yeah, that was your time.
For the shooting range.
Shooting range.
For the indoor 22s.
There was also a wild story that Adam Kahn kept lions in the basement.
Yeah. When I bought it, the woman told me, she had these lion cages, tiger cages. I said, what do you do with tigers? She says, like if people would come on the property, let the tigers out. I said, isn't that what you do? You know, one home tiger, like, they're just a lot of silly shit. It's just a big home. It's a great home, but a big home. Yes, sir.
Two questions. What was the biggest project rehab in this place? And did you run across any military ghosts in this place?
Okay, which was the biggest project I did here?
Biggest project? And have you seen or got involved with any ghosts in this place?
Well, for the biggest project, the hardest project for me that scared me the most when I bought it was the roof.
The roof?
Took 2 years to do the roof. You know, because it's poured concrete, the roof, then it's got sleepers, wood, and then sheathing, and then the slate. It's pretty high up there. So that was the scariest. And probably one of the biggest single, cool things I did. All the gardens were a big project for me also. As far as ghosts, I'm here 29 years. I haven't seen any. If I did, I'd charge them. But my staff has, like most of them, seen them.
I don't know what ghosts
mean. I guess that say that there's ghosts in the thing. But I have not. The closest I could say that I could think of, when I lived in 403 up on the top floor, my dogs would be in the living room. And a lot of times at night, they would bark at this corner and wouldn't go over there. I couldn't get them over there. But I don't know what that meant. And the last one was probably about a year ago. A friend of mine had a spiritual healer here in 400. And she said she saw ghosts and she took, she's got a picture of it all. But I'm really not believing.
Missing cadets?
No, just the girls. So that's on this end of the house, and my den is on the total other end, on these two wings. So one morning, I go and talk to my wife, and she says, I was sleeping last night, and then something, I felt something on my legs, then something coming up underneath the bed. I said, well, listen, she says, 2 nights ago. Got up, I was scared, I didn't see anything, and I wasn't sleeping. That night, in the den, all of a sudden, all my lights were out in the den. Nothing else, just the den lights. Then 5 minutes later, they come if they come on. 10 minutes later, they all walk. So I had about 6 times. So I kept trying to see if there's a circuit. I checked the circuit breaker. I put the other lights on outside. Then the doors open, and the den just kept going off. We still have that. I don't know what that was. If they're ghosts, they ain't hurting anybody. And it's always a pleasure to help. Okay? And you guys, you're part of the history. What makes this building special is the people that have occupied. So you guys add that to it. If I built this house today, it wouldn't be the same.
Mr. Hastings, maybe Paul and Bernadette, you want to go up? I know they wanted to make a contribution to the Wounded Warriors also.
Yeah, I have to be I support them. As a matter of fact, I've been to the War College in Carlisle. I'm very friendly now. is a trip.